How big should our functions be? The size of our screens? 50 lines? 5 lines? Or none of the above? Welcome to Le Coding. I'm Letícia Baleiro, and today we're gonna talk about how functions should be in clean code. Uncle Bob says that a function should do only one thing. If a function does multiple things, then you should break it into smaller functions, as it's much easier to read and understand the information broken into smaller pieces. For example, don't do this: a function to make an order, which registers the client, adds a discount, updates the inventory, and saves the order. It's doing 4 things. Instead of writing one big function and a comment on every step, you should have small separate functions with clear names that tells us what it does. If you need to change something on the saveOrder function, you don't need to read the code inside registerClient function to get the point. Reading registerClient will be a waste of time in this case. Uncle Bob says it's polite to give the other people the option to read or not a part of the code. The same idea applies to classes. They should also be short, and the consequences is that our files become also short, making it much easier to digest information because it's broken into smaller pieces. Another rule about functions is that you should avoid passing booleans, also called flags, into a function. If you are doing this, it's probably because you have an if statement that could be broken into 2 separate functions. If you just want to set a variable to true or false, then it's okay to pass a boolean. Otherwise, if this boolean is used to determine if a function should do one thing or another, then you should avoid it. For example, don't do this: a function to create a file based on the location and, depending on if it's temporary or not, uses a different directory. Instead, we should have 2 separate functions like this. Don't pass more than 3 arguments into a function. If you have a function that needs to receive more than 3, you should pass an object that contains all those arguments. It makes it easier to read. So don't do this: a signup function that receives 5 arguments. Do this instead: a function that receives an account credentials object that contains all those 5 arguments. This way, we don't have to read all of those to understand what a function needs. Account credentials is enough. It's the same thing as we saw for functions. It's polite to give the user the option to read what is inside the object or not. Another important rule is that only void functions should have side effects, because they change the state of the system and return nothing. But by convention, functions that return something should never have side effects. The main reason is that everyone should feel safe to call a return function knowing that it doesn't change the state of the system. For example, here's a void function that changes the state of the system, which is expected, by adding a grid to a list. And here is a function that returns the average grade of the students, not changing the state of any variable outside its own scope. What we should avoid is something like this: a function that returns something and also changes the state of the system, which is, in this case, the average grade variable. Next rule is, don't repeat yourself. You may start writing duplicated code, and that's okay if you're trying to make it work. But after doing this, you should put some effort into cleaning it, moving the duplicated code into a function that can be easily accessed in both places. If you want to go deeper into clean code, I'll post a link in the description to Uncle Bob's book, and you can also check my video explaining what clean code is. In the next video, we are gonna be talking about the Boy Scout rule and some other rules from clean code. So make sure to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss anything, and if you're enjoying this series, don't forget to hit the like button.